this video, we will look at what the central processing unit in a computer is and what it does. The central processing unit, or CPU, is often referred to as the brains of the computer. Whilst this is a little misleading, as it doesn't think, it is responsible for all the processing the computer does. Without it, computers would not be able to do anything with the data they store. First, let's take a look at what the CPU looks like. Here is a motherboard with a CPU on it. You can't see the CPU at the moment as it is under the big piece of metal called the heatsink. As the CPU carries out millions of calculations per second, it gets very hot. We need to get the heat away from the processor before it damages it. To do this, we use a heatsink, which draws it out while a fan on top blows air onto it to move the heat away. A fan on the case then blows the hot air out of the computer. This is one of the reasons you may notice that computer rooms without air conditioning can quickly get warm. All the computers in there are blowing out hot air. You'll notice a Raspberry Pi doesn't have a heatsink. This is because at its normal speed, it doesn't generate enough heat to need one. Generally, the faster the processor is running, the more heat it will produce. The CPU sits under the heatsink. Don't be tempted to take the heatsink off at home. When a heatsink is first put on, a special paste is put on to ensure there is a connection between your CPU and the heatsink to allow the heat to be transferred. Removing and replacing the heatsink without fresh paste will reduce the efficiency of the heatsink. Here is the CPU itself. Inside there are millions of electrical switches called transistors. The most modern CPUs can contain over a billion. These transistors are used to build circuitry inside, including logic gates, which are covered elsewhere in this course. Within the CPU, two of the most important parts are the control unit and arithmetic logic unit. The control unit coordinates parts of the processor when an instruction is received. The arithmetic logic unit, or ALU, performs calculations and comparisons. The CPU does its processing by repeatedly carrying out three steps. These are fetch, decode, execute. Let's take a look at the fetch, decode, execute cycle. All the instructions and data for the CPU are stored in memory as binary. In the fetch step, the instructions retrieve from the memory to the CPU. The CPU uses something called the program counter to keep track of where it can find the instruction it needs. Once the instruction is loaded into the CPU, it needs to work out what the instruction means. It does this in the decode step. Finally, the computer has to carry out the instruction during the execute step. This could be a number of things, including loading data from memory, storing data in memory, or performing a calculation. The processor will carry out this cycle over and over, millions of times per second. In this video, we've looked at what the CPU is and how it works.